Hello and welcome to the new tutorial from Cocoon FX Media. Today we're going to look at WebMail and how to start adding spam filters to stop those pesky, horrible spam emails you constantly get. Several things to just point out. Often or not, at the moment, HMRC and the bank seem to be sending an awful lot of emails with attachments. These are spam. HMRC and the banks do not contact you or do not send anything via email of any significance. So if you come across any of those, I would highly recommend that you do not download the zip files and you do not open or click the links. This goes for any email with voicemail attachments. These will contain viruses. The simple solution is if you're in doubt, just delete the email and mark it as spam. However, if there are stuff still coming through and you want to get rid of them, then what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to do a first line of defense, if you like. So to get to your webmail, what you need to do is just go to your website and type in webmail just as it is up there, and this will redirect you to this page. So type in your email address and password, so click in login, and you want to stop the auto load, and then you'll be confronted with the following. So, first thing we need to do is we need to create an email filtering. This is where you start the process for stopping those pesky emails. So what we need to do is create a filter. So in here it gives it a name, rule one. Sometimes we want to differentiate rules because we may want to expand on them or make them tighter. Also, it's good to have a logical name in case you're stopping real email coming through. So on this one, we'll call this Dirk, and it's because this guy here sent me a request for a donation. I don't know him, or never know him, and I don't trust that email or that email address, and I certainly don't trust where this has come from. That does not look like a standard email address. So what I'm going to do is copy that. There's several ways you can do that. And I'm going to create this rule. And from the drop down, you've got various different options. And you do from equals to, or you can do other matches. And put dklover@tacoma.com in here. We want to disregard the message. But we can have other options as well, but discard message will stop it from coming at all. There's also some hints and tips in here on what you can do with regards to creating spam filters. So if I click create on that, that now has successfully created my first rule. So what we can do is we can test that rule. And what we could do is return to here, and there's a, you see the Dirk there. What we're going to do is we're going to test this email through this little test filter, and it will say, here we go, filter is set up to at least one snippet delivery or other action. No other action or deliveries will occur. That basically means that's blocked. Just to show you I mean, if I did this, normal delivery will occur. So you see that there's two clear separations. So we know that my email address works. What we're going to do also is we're going to create a second rule, and we're going to take just the domain part of this filter. We're going to click back. I'm going to create a new filter called Dirk2. Again, from, but what we want to do is we want to say it contains part of that web address at Tacoma, etc. And again, we want to put it in the bin. So if we create that, and if we click back to our return menus, I'm just going to quickly grab that. And if we go back and we just do a little test, and we'll do test.com. So there we go. That will not come through. So anything from that domain there will be blocked. I really don't recommend you putting a block on Gmail or anything to do with Gmail, only if you know the exact web address. What we can also do, if we took that web address, is we can take this here, and we can also put this as a rule, as a filter. In fact, we could do this part here, and what we'll do is we'll create a filter and call this body Dirk. Sounds a bit weird. And we're going to select the body. This is the body of the email, and we want it to put contains, and fingers crossed this will work. Money has been donated, so we create that rule. We click that to the filters. Let's put that in here and test filter. So there we go. It's been blocked. If we put it in and remove the word donated, let's see what happens. Normal delivery will occur. So it's not exactly bulletproof, but you can have as many filters as you want on our hosting packages. This will start to eradicate any email. On my main account, I've got 10 filters set up and some extra security on the website, and I probably get one or two spam emails a week now. But if you've got any questions, please contact us on hosting@cocoonfxmedia.co.uk, or you can visit our website on www.cocoonfxmedia.co.uk, or follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Thank you for watching, and I hope this is of interest.